Hello students, welcome back. Welcome to Easy Biology Tutorials. So in the last class, we were already discussing that the brain is having the three parts. There are three parts of the brain. The first part is the forebrain. That is also known as the prosencephalon. Second part is the midbrain, known as the mesencephalon. The third part is the hindbrain and is known as the rhombencephalon. So now we are going to proceed to the next part and the next slide, and this is forebrain. Forebrain, it is the anteriormost part. Anteriormost part means sabse aage wala part. It consists of two parts, the cerebrum and the diencephalon. The first part is the cerebrum and the next part is the diencephalon. Diencephalon is made up of two parts, that is the thalamus and the hypothalamus, that is making the forebrain. So students, forebrain mein abhi aap dekh sakte ho that there are basically the two parts. The first one is the cerebrum, the second one is the diencephalon. Diencephalon is made up of two parts, the hypothalamus and the thalamus. Hanji. Now let us discuss about the cerebrum. Cerebrum is the largest part. It is made up of two cerebral hemispheres. These two cerebral hemispheres are held together by a tract of nerve fibers that is known as the corpus callosum. Corpus callosum is basically a tract of nerve fibers that is joining the two hemispheres of the cerebrum. The outer part of the cerebrum is known as the cerebral cortex. It has convolutions and depressions and is formed of gray matter. The color gray is due to the presence of the cell bodies, or we can say the non-myelinated axon neuron fibers. And the inner part is made up of white matter. White matter is made up of myelinated axon fibers. Now you can remember that with age, our hair get gray. So you can remember the gray part or the gray matter is the outermost part of the brain. And the white matter is the innermost part of the brain. Yeah. So students, you can remember this in this way. Yeah. Okay. Okay, let us go to the next slide. In the next slide, we are having the regions of the cerebrum. The first region is the cerebral cortex, that is the motor area. Cortex ke andar jo hai, there is the motor area, there is a sensory area, and there is an association area. मोटर एरिया इज रिलेटेड विद अवर वॉलेंट्री और जो भी चीजें हम करते हैं बाय माइंड बाय ब्रेन उससे रिलेटेड है. सेंसरी एरिया इज रिलेटेड टू अवर सेंसेस एंड एसोसिएशन एरिया इज बेसिकली एक्टिंग अ लिंकेज बिटवीन द मोटर एरिया एंड द सेंसरी एरिया. ठीक है. सो देर आर थ्री रीजन्स इन द ब्रेन, द मोटर एरिया, द सेंसरी एरिया एंड द एसोसिएशन एरिया. तो मोटर एरिया के अंदर हम पढ़ लेते हैं, it controls the voluntary movement of the muscles. Sensory area controls the functioning of the sense organs. And association area, it is neither clearly sensory nor motor in function. It is responsible for intersensory association, memory and communication. Intersensory matlab ki sense organs ke beech mein jo relationship hota hai, sense organs and voluntary थिंकिंग के बीच में जो रिलेशन होता है वो एसोसिएशन एरिया को संभालता है. हाँ जी. नेक्स्ट पार्ट हमने ये पढ़ लिया था ऑलरेडी दैट इंटेलिजेंस मेमोरी जजमेंट लर्निंग थिंकिंग एंड आर्टिकुलेट स्पीच इज बेसिकली रेगुलेटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ द सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स. हाँ जी. सो स्टूडेंट्स, द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रेन इज डायनसेफेलन. The first part of diencephalon is thalamus. It is the structure around which the cerebrum wraps. सेरेब्रम के अंदर हमने जो पढ़ा कि सेरेब्रम का सेरेब्रम इज कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ टू पार्ट्स, सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स and the inner to the cerebral cortex is the thalamus, and thalamus is having two parts, the bigger thalamus part and smaller hypothalamus part. So it is a structure which wraps around the, which is situated between the cerebrum and around which the cerebrum wraps. It is a coordinating center for sensory and motor impulses. It coordinates the sensory and motor impulses. हाँ जी. Hypothalamus can be seen below the thalamus. It regulates the temperature, thirst, hunger and emotions. ठीक है, जो hypothalamus है ये मास्टर ऑफ द मास्टर ग्लैंड है. हमारा मास्टर ग्लैंड कौन होता है स्टूडेंट्स? पिट्यूटरी. द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड इज द मास्टर ग्लैंड एंड द मास्टर ऑफ द मास्टर इज हाइपोथैलेमस. हाइपोथैलेमस इज एबल टू रेगुलेट अवर टेम्परेचर. द बॉडी टेम्परेचर इज रेगुलेटेड बाय हाइपोथैलेमस. द थ्रस्ट इज रेगुलेटेड बाय हाइपोथैलेमस. व्हेनेवर वी स्वेट अलॉट, व्हेनेवर देयर इज अलॉट ऑफ हॉट आउटसाइड, तो फिर हमें प्यास लगती है, दैट इज रेगुलेटेड बाय हाइपोथैलेमस. And the emotions are also regulated by hypothalamus. हाँ जी. Students, hypothalamus secretes the hypothalamic hormones, and the hypothalamic hormones controls the pituitary gland. हमें पता है कि मास्टर ऑफ द मास्टर ग्लैंड बेसिकली करता क्या है. मास्टर ऑफ द मास्टर ग्लैंड सिक्रीट द हाइपोथैलेमिक हार्मोन. हाइपोथैलेमिक हार्मोन जो है वो पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड को स्टिमुलेट करते हैं फर्दर टू रिलीज डिफरेंट हार्मोन्स. हाइपोथैलेमस कंट्रोल्स स्लीप, वेकफुलनेस, ब्लड प्रेशर एंड हार्ट रेट एक्सेट्रा. ये चीजें कौन कंट्रोल करता है? हमारा हाइपोथैलेमस. हाइपोथैलेमस हमारा स्लीप साइकिल रेगुलेट करता है, हमारा ब्लड प्रेशर रेगुलेट करता है, हमारा हार्ट रेट रेगुलेट करता है. ऑफ कोर्स व्हेनेवर वी आर इन अ स्ट्रेस और वी आर इन अ टेंशन तो हमें नींद प्रॉपर नहीं आती है. क्यों नहीं आती है? बिकॉज ऑफ द हाइपोथैलेमस इज रेगुलेटेड रेगुलेटिंग दीज थिंग्स. हाँ जी. सो इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट द फोर ब्रेन मोर. The inner parts of the cerebral hemispheres and a group of associated deep structures like amygdala, hippocampus, hypothalamus together constitute the limbic system or the limbic lobe. जो inner part of the cerebral hemisphere है, cerebral hemisphere के outer part है outer cortex, and the inner to the outer cortex, the structures like amygdala, hippocampus and hypothalamus are present. And they constitute the limbic system. Now the next question that arises is, what is the limbic system? What is the limbic system? You have to answer the question that what is the limbic system? Hypothalamus, amygdala, and hippocampus. These are the parts of the brain. Or we can say these are the parts of the forebrain that constitute the limbic system. ठीक है? Or the limbic, they are present in the limbic lobe. Now these this limbic lobe, ये जो limbic lobe है आप देख सकते हो, this is the hippocampus, this is the amygdala, this is hypothalamus. These all things, ये वाली जो सारी things है in the diagram you can see in here. यहाँ पे ये जो सारी चीजें हैं. हाँ जी. These are regulating and these are responsible for regulating the sexual behavior, the motivations, the emotions of a person, the excitement in a person, the pleasure, the rage, the fear, etc. मतलब overall the nature and the behavior of the person is controlled by the limbic system. The nature, behavior, we can say the temper, the overall personality of the person is regulated by the limbic system. हाँ जी, okay. So midbrain and the mesencephaly. Now we are going to talk. We had already talked about the forebrain. What is the forebrain? What are the parts of the forebrain? What is limbic lobe? What is the function of the limbic lobe? What is diencephalon? The function of thalamus and hypothalamus. Now we are going to talk about the midbrain and the mesencephalon. Students, so midbrain hai jo it is located between the thalamus. Thalamus is the upper part of the brain basically. Front anterior part of the brain and pons. Pons is the hinder or the we can say posterior or sabse piche wala jo part hai that is the pons. So mid hai jo that is located in the middle. Midbrain is located between the thalamus. Thalamus and the hypothalamus part is the interior part and the pons part of the brain is the posterior part. A canal that is cerebral aqueduct. The name of the canal, the name of the canal is cerebral aqueduct, passes through the midbrain. This cerebral aqueduct passes through the midbrain. And now the midbrain further consists of the four round lobes. Corpora quadri gemina. Quad means four, gemina means lobes. ठीक है, corpora quadri gemina are the four lobes that are located in the midbrain. Their anterior pair is the center of the visual reflexes and the posterior pair is the center of the auditory reflexes. इसका जो आगे वाला part है student that is responsible for the vision. पीछे जो midbrain का पीछे वाला part is responsible for the audition. Yes. So, last part of the brain is the hindbrain. It consists of the cerebellum, the pons, and the medulla oblongata. Cerebellum. Cerebellum is also known as the small cerebrum. The pons and the medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata is the last part of the brain, and it is in association with the spinal cord. Thus, midbrain and the hindbrain form the brain stem. Brain की जो stem है, brain की जो लड़ी है, वो कौन बनाता है? Midbrain and the hindbrain. Now you from this you arise a question. Who forms the brain stem? So this is the basic thing. Yes. So let us come to know about cerebellum. What is cerebellum? Cerebellum is the first part of the rhombencephalon. What is rhombencephalon? Rhombencephalum is the scientific name for the hindbrain. So cerebellum is also known as the little cerebrum. It has a very very convoluted surface to accommodate more neurons. ये जो cerebrum brain के अंदर जो पत्ते like structure हम बनाते हैं, this is the cerebrum. You can see here it is indicated in the blue part. This is in the blue part. इसकी जो होती है surface बहुत ही ज़्यादा folded होती है, deeply and highly folded होती है, so that more and more neurons can be accommodated in this place. It coordinates muscular activities and the body equilibrium. What do it coordinates? ये हमारी body का equilibrium संभालती है. इसीलिए जब कोई person drink करता है, उसके बाद उसका body equilibrium नहीं handle हो पाता उससे, because the cerebrum, cerebellum, जो wine है या drink है, वो basically alcoholic जो भी drink होती है, that directly affects the cerebellum. सेरेबेलम पे जाके अटैक करती है, जिसकी वजह से वो पर्सन जो है दैट इज नॉट एबल टू have body equilibrium. उसकी बॉडी में इक्विलिब्रियम नहीं होता, वो खड़े नहीं हो पाता, वो उसकी बॉडी कोऑर्डिनेट नहीं कर पाती. द वॉलंटरी एक्शंस आर इफेक्टेड. सो नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज द पोन्स वेरोली. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ द फाइबर ट्रैक्स दैट इंटरकनेक्ट डिफरेंट रीजन्स ऑफ द ब्रेन. पोन्स वेरोली क्या करता है स्टूडेंट्स, इट कनेक्ट्स द डिफरेंट रीजन्स ऑफ द ब्रेन टू ईच अदर. ठीक है, जैसे कि मिड ब्रेन और हाइंड ब्रेन के अंदर क्या कर रहा है, पॉन्स इज फॉर्मिंग द इंटरकनेक्शन. इट कोऑर्डिनेट्स द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द आई एंड द ईयर एंड रेगुलेट्स रेस्पिरेशन. नाउ डू यू रिमेम्बर दैट, कैन यू रिमेम्बर दैट रेस्पिरेशन के अंदर हमने किया था, रेस्पिरेशन कंट्रोल सेंटर. Yes, students. So respiratory control center कहाँ पे present था? I should write it as a respiratory control center. Respiratory control center was located in the pons. Yes, in the pons, students. So it coordinates the activities of eye, ear, and regulates respiration. Next, it is interconnected to the spinal cord, medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata is a bilkul last la part jo hota hai na, ye wala brain ke andar yahan pe inhone indicate bhi kiya hua hai. This is medulla. This is the last part of the brain and it is connected to the spinal cord. Medulla is in the interconnection between the spinal cord and the brain. It controls respiration. It controls the cardiovascular reflexes. It controls the gastric secretions. It controls the peristalsis. It controls the salivation. It controls the vomiting. It controls the sneezing. It controls the coughing. So, हमने जब this is the last part of our human physiology, brain वाला chapter, brain के बाद endocrine वाला chapter. So basically मैं इन दोनों chapters को same ही constitute करती हूँ. I don't consider it as different chapters. जो brain and endocrine वाला chapter है, that is the same chapter for me. हमने पढ़ा था, हमने सबसे पहले start किया digestion के बाद. Digestion वाला chapter as you know कि अभी syllabus में नहीं है, तो digestion के बाद we had included respiration. ठीक है, रेस्पिरेशन में हमने रेस्पिरेटरी कंट्रोल सेंटर किया था, वो भी मेड्यूला में था. कार्डियोवैस्कुलर कंट्रोल सेंटर किया था, वो भी मेड्यूला में था. गैस्ट्रिक सिक्रीशंस अगर हम डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम को रिवाइज करके देखते हैं, तो स्टमक का भी जो सिक्रीशंस को कंट्रोल करता है हमारा मेड्यूला ऑब्लोंगेटा. सो मेड्यूला ऑब्लोंगेटा इज द मेजर कंट्रोल सेंटर फॉर एवरी इनवॉलेंट्री एक्टिविटी इन द बॉडी. इट ऑल्सो कंट्रोल्स द वॉमिटिंग, स्नीजिंग एंड कफिंग. बेसिकली दीज आर द एलर्जिक रिएक्शंस. तो एलर्जिक रिएक्शंस को भी कंट्रोल करने के लिए कौन रिस्पॉन्सिबल है, मेड्यूला ऑब्लोंगेटा. नाउ लेट अस रीड अबाउट द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. वी आर नाउ एट अवर सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम, दैट इज द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. नाउ स्पाइनल कॉर्ड की डेफिनेशन के बारे में यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर दैट इट इज एनक्लोज्ड विद इन द स्पाइनल कैनाल. ब्रेन को कौन क्लोज कर रहा था स्टूडेंट्स, द पार्ट दैट वॉज रेगुलेटिंग, द पार्ट दैट वॉज कैरिंग अप द ब्रेन, द पार्ट दैट वॉज प्रोटेक्टिंग द ब्रेन, दैट वॉज बेसिकली द ब्रेन बॉक्स. लेकिन स्पाइनल कॉर्ड को कौन कर रहा है प्रोटेक्ट, द स्पाइनल कैनाल. द स्पाइनल कैनाल इज प्रोटेक्टिंग द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. ऑफ द वर्टेब्रल कॉलम. वर्टेब्रल कॉलम के अंदर जो स्पाइनल कैनाल है वो क्या करता है स्टूडेंट्स, इट कंट्रोल्स द, इट प्रोटेक्ट्स द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. यस, तो जैसे कि हमने ब्रेन के अराउंड देखे थे स्टूडेंट्स, ब्रेन हैड थ्री आर्किनॉइड, पिया मैटर एंड ड्यूरा मैटर जो लेयर्स थी ब्रेन के अराउंड, थ्री मेनिंजेस, three meningeal layers between the around the brain. वैसे ही spinal cord is also protected by meninges. The next point is defining the same thing. it is also protected by meninges. Meninges protect the spinal cord as well. It has a central canal that is containing the cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebrospinal. Cerebro is the word used for brain. So ये जो CSF fluid है, basically cerebrospinal fluid. इसके नाम से ही पता चल रहा है कि that is present in brain, that is present in spinal cord as well. क्योंकि cerebro word भी आ रहा है इसमें. Cerebro is the word used for brain. Spinal is the word that is used for spinal cord. It has a central canal consisting of cerebrospinal fluid. The spinal cord is basically made up of, you have to remember, brain ke andar kya tha? Brain ke andar maine aapko bola tha, you have to remember with the graying of hair. Can you remember, can you recall the thing that I told you, graying of hair. Graying of hair ka matlab, gray matter makes the outermost layer of the brain. Now students, in this, the things are very opposite to each other. The spinal cord in the spinal cord basically the white matter forms the outermost part and the gray matter forms the innermost part. You have to remember that कि brain के अंदर जो चीज बाहर थी, spinal cord के अंदर वो चीज क्या है, अंदर है. Students, ठीक है? Brain के अंदर जो gray part था, that was outermost. Spinal cord के अंदर जो gray part है, that is innermost and white part is the outermost. So I think the structure of spinal cord is clear to you all. Now let us go further. Hanji. Functions. Students, what are the functions of the spinal cord? Spinal cord ka ek basic function to aapne dekha hi hai, that is conduction of impulses to and from the brain. Conduction of impulses to and from the brain and act as the action. It is the center of the spinal reflexes. Spinal cord is basically a cord and that is acting an intermediate stage between the brain and the other organs. The first function of the spinal cord hai ki wo kya kar rahi hai, intermediate ki tarah act kar rahi hai. And second function of the spinal cord is that it acts as the center of the spinal reflexes. So, students, in the next part, we have already covered up with the central nervous system. In the central nervous system, we have seen the brain and the spinal cord. Let us have a revision of this thing, students. We had already covered up with the central nervous system. So in the central nervous system, we had covered our topic of brain. Brain is basically having three parts. The first part is the forebrain. Next part is the midbrain and the third part is the hindbrain. Then we have done with the spinal cord. That was the central nervous system. ये center के अंदर जो भी हमारे parts आ रहे थे, nervous control and coordination वाले organs आ रहे थे, उसमें brain, spinal cord were performing the major function. Now we are going to read about the peripheral nervous system. But before this, you should know the difference between the peripheral and, let's see, question. What is the difference between CNS and PNS? स्टूडेंट दिस इज अ वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन, इसको बिल्कुल बेसिक क्वेश्चन की तरह आपने डील करना है एंड देन यू हैव टू आंसर अबाउट दिस. कि बेसिक आपका सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम एंड पेरिफेरल नर्वस सिस्टम के अंदर आपको डिफरेंस दिख क्या रहा है, लग क्या रहा है. सो यू हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द CNS एंड द PNS. यू हैव टू राइट ऑल द एस्पेक्ट्स दैट यू थिंक, ऑल द एस्पेक्ट्स दैट यू थिंक, जस्ट एज अ टू मार्क क्वेश्चन. टू मार्क क्वेश्चन की तरह उसको लिख के दिखाना है. If you are able to solve this question, I'm sure you are going to crack your examination. Okay, students. So, यहीं पे जो हमारी आज की क्लास है वो खत्म होती है. And okay, students. So that was all for today. I hope you got it. I hope you understood it. I hope there is no negative review for that. So I can tell you about this. Now, students, let me go. Take care and have a nice day.